Hey guys, it's Greg from Beastie Geeks. Thank you so much for watching our channel. In this video, I want to show you a prototype of Voidfall, latest game by Mindclash Games. Voidfall is 4X Euro-styled game where players are going to lead last three stands of humanity, which are trying to repel and fight titled Voidborn. So the game offers us not only Euro-style experience, but we also have player interaction, we don't have dice, so everything counts on your strategy, and that's the best part for me, because I'm the worst with the dice, so I hope that finally I have 4X game where dice are not going to decide if I am a winner or not. So let's check out what are our highlights and impressions after a few plays using the prototype. We are not going to score the game or anything. We want to just share with you our impressions after those few plays. So let's check this out. I love the story behind the game. We have a dystopian world where the power of mankind and possibility of conquest of the galaxy came from Voidborn, cosmic beings from another dimension. Thanks to technology and knowledge granted by Voidborn, the humankind's cosmic empire grew and reached distant systems. Now, when the hunger of Voidborn can be satisfied, interdimensional rifts opened and corruption spread through the galaxy, taking control over the world. Players, as leaders of remaining human great houses, are going to purge the galactic corruption and repel the Voidborn. I really enjoy this new approach to the theme of the cosmic opera. It is again a war, but this time we have this virtual enemy and mechanic of corruption influencing everything and everybody. Every single game from Mindclash looks like a small work of art. The same is with Voidfall, which uses that blue, purple and black color palette, looking just stunning on the table. We only played the prototype, but I can only imagine what kind of visual upgrades Mindclash prepared for us. They are also introducing some quality of life improvements in the form of dials tracking our production and amount of resources. Of course, in some games, resources are also a beautiful part of the game, like in Everdell, where each resource is just a small cute element. But when there is a lot of production and we need to manage a lot of tokens, I definitely prefer dials. I love what they did when it comes to the management of miniatures on the map. Everyone who played Twilight Imperium knows that annoying situation when another mini should be placed on the tile and there is literally no space for at least 4 minis already on this tile. In Voidborn, every miniature has its own plastic stands with slots for cubes. When building a fleet, we just add another cube to the stand, not another miniature. That keeps the board much cleaner and it's easy to see and count fleet power. Combats are super clear and intuitive. As the rulebook says, you know who wins the moment the invasion starts. The most basic combat looks like this. One fleet attacks another one. Then players need to check the initiative. Who has the higher value attacks first and deals one damage. Then if the opponent survives, they also deal one damage. And so on until one fleet survives. Of course, we can modify combat flow thanks to absorption mechanics, technologies, sector defenses, and so on. I love that we don't have dice to determine the winner. Your strategy counts, not luck. What is amazing when it comes to Mindclash games is that their titles are always crazy thematic. All actions players can take are always logical and somehow connected to the theme of the game. That helps with immersion a lot. There are games on the market which give the impression that mechanics and theme were created in separate rooms, then they mixed both elements and the game popped out. Fortunately, that never was a case of games from Mindclash, and Voidfall is not an exception. Mindclash games specialize in worker placement games, so making a title that uses cards with sets of actions allows players to interact, and focus on exploration is very refreshing. We have already seen in their previous games how thematic and innovative their games can be. They gave us gigantic anachrony with loads of mechanics, beautiful components, and the game is in 45th place on BGG ranking. Next is crazy immersive Trickerion, allowing us to be a magician performing tricks on the biggest shows ever. Then we have Cerebria, mind-blowing area control where as Bliss and Gloom, players are building the personality of a human. And the last title still not shipped, Perseverance. Two games in one that can be played as a campaign. Honestly, we have the biggest expectations when it comes to the games from Mindclash Games. And Voidfall feels like another big title. The game serves us real 4X experience, tight competition, and even mechanics of events at the start of each round of the game. And let's face it, events in Eurogames are not existing. Voidfall can be played not only as a typical competitive title, we also going to have co-op and solo play. And still, that's not all. The game is going to have a few different scenarios with a different setup, tiles, rules, etc. In the prototype, we had three scenarios for competitive mode and one for co-op, but I am sure that's not all what we are going to get. As the Voidfall is a Euro game, forget about tension or aggressive plays seen in classic 4X games where a gigantic armada is attacking another one. That brings the biggest con of the game, downtime. The game is more strategic and focuses on optimization so the turn of one player can take an eternity. Maybe these cases are not cons per se, but you should remember them. Learning the game was a challenge, maybe because the rulebook was still a doc file or maybe not. Overwhelming was the number of icons, which were not very intuitive and not really recurring. Each time we played the game, we had the feeling that every single icon is unique and is not used anywhere else and means something else, even if that was not true. Maybe adding some texts with an explanation would fix this, or maybe Mindclash must work more on this iconography. Nevertheless, we enjoyed the Voidfall and the game is added to our list of must-haves. So those are our highlights and our impressions after playing a prototype version of Voidfall. I must say we always have very high expectations when it comes to the games from Mindclash Games, and Voidfall is something we expected. It's not a downfall, it's nothing, it's not disappointing at all. I must say that Voidfall for me is maybe on the same shelf as Cerebria when it comes to complexity and how it was challenging to understand and go through all the rules. So if you are not very advanced in the board games or in the Euro games, this is going to be a challenge. For me, games from Mindclash Games are should be a golden standard when it comes to Euro games, because not only they focuses on mechanics, but also they always give us very immersive worlds where everything is connected and works. So if you like 4X games and you are not afraid of this high complexity, in my opinion, high complexity of Voidfall, or you just love their games, follow their Kickstarter campaign. Let's see how this campaign unfolds. And thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video.